This is America. This used to be America.
It ain't no more, okay?
I know it ain't. All right, there's a rising call for the creation of an alternative to the U.S. dollar in the form of a new world currency. Bloomberg columnist Kevin Hassett refers to the dollar as the Mickey Mouse currency. He points out, and Carol, you may know this, that when you go to Disney, apparently you could trade one U.S. dollar for one Disney dollar. And Kevin says, well, that may be superfluous now because they're pretty much the same thing. Am I getting your views here wrong, Kevin?
No, that's about right. Although I am a big fan of Disney, so it's not necessarily an insult to be a Mickey Mouse currency these
days. Is the problem here with the U.S. dollar, and why do I see in your column that you appear to be agreeing with economist Joseph Stiglitz?
Well, you know, the fact is that the black helicopter people have been saying that, oh, we're going to do away with the dollar and move towards one world currency. And it's been kind of a key conspiracy theorist idea for a long time. And what I did in the last week or so is really pour myself into the literature on why we might want to have one world currency. And there's some pretty good arguments. I could see us moving towards, as a global financial system, having an alternative to the dollar be this sort of primary unit of account. And Keynes called for this long, long ago, right before the Bretton Woods conference. And it looks like there are a lot of people, including Joe Stiglitz, including the Chinese and the Russians, trying to move in that direction. So I think it's something that really could happen. It's something we need to pay attention to.
But something that would take a long time, right, Kevin?
No, it wouldn't really, because right now what's going on is that developing countries in particular feel like in order to prove to the world that they have the liquidity they need to be stable, that they need to hold a lot of dollars. And if they en masse all decide to hold some other thing, perhaps something issued by the International Monetary Fund, then they could move all that dollar demand to demand for another type of currency. And then once they did that, then it could be that you're going to have a bandwagon effect and a lot of other countries, including Europe and the U.S., might eventually have to play along.
I don't know if you've come across this, Kevin, but some large religions may have a problem with one world currency.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm talking about. But, you know, there are a lot of things that are wrong about the current system and things that Stiglitz has pointed out. So, for example, since the developing world has to hold a lot of dollars in order to prove that they have liquidity, then basically what they're doing is making interest-free loans to the United States. And that's not really just to have the poorest countries on earth, you know, pouring resources to the United States in order to hold dollars. Whereas if something like the International Monetary Fund issued a currency, then maybe those profits from producing the currency that people need to hold in reserve could go back towards the developing world.
Hey, Kevin, will all this clear once kind of the dust settles? And, I mean, I know everybody's worried about deficits, certainly the deficit of the United States, and that's why they're getting even more and more worried about the dollar. Mm-hmm. But let's assume, you know, the economy gets back on track and things start to improve and the deficit goes down. I mean, will all this talk just go away?
No, I really don't think so. But I think that you're right that one reason why this talk has really lifted is that the U.S. deficit situation is so terrible that people are a little bit worried that maybe the U.S. dollar isn't going to be the best place to park your money over the next few years. But I think there's this other thing, which is the equity between the developed world and the developing world that needs to be addressed. And so the developing world is throwing capital at the developed world, and really it should go in the other direction.
Are the people, though, that are concerned also concerned because they are holding so many U.S. dollars? I mean, China brings this up, right? But it's not in China's best interest to pull investors out of U.S. dollars either.
Right. So right now, if everybody were to abandon the dollar, then that might be a problem for the value of all of China's assets that are in dollars. But I think that a kind of orderly progression towards using other reserve currencies, maybe the creation of one by the IMF, is something that, whether the U.S. likes it or not, I believe is likely to happen. And so you need to start to think about what's going to happen if the developing world coalesces around the idea that we should have this new currency. Maybe, you know, Keynes called it the Bancor. We'd have this new currency that they all use as their reserve. Is their main reserve. If that starts to happen, it's going to be a fundamentally different world, and they've got a strong incentive to do that.
All right, hey, Kevin, thanks so much for joining us. Kevin Hassett there, Director of Economic Policy Studies at the American Enterprise Institute, also a Bloomberg News columnist, and the opinions that he expresses are his own and not necessarily those of Bloomberg LP.
I have a feeling you might express them too, though.
I enjoy reading Kevin's column, let's just say that. You can find it on the Bloomberg NI Hassett.
Definitely check it out.
Or you can check it out on Bloomberg.com.